New at 11, a million-dollar mistake.
The 7 investigators asking some tough questions about a top executive at the Detroit Fire Department's past and a big-ticket purchase that did not go as planned.
Makes you feel kind of bad, you know, like all the work that you put into the is just thrown out the window.
Tonight, investigator Simon Chiquette getting answers from the head of the Detroit Fire Department and from the mayor's office.
The head of the Detroit Fire Department tells us for years the city has badly needed to improve its fleet, and now they are spending millions to do just that. But now, one of the purchases is raising eyebrows, and the city is responding.
We had engines that leaked water down the street that we needed salt trucks to follow in the winter. We had pickup trucks for squads. We weren't on life support. We were in hospice.
These brave firefighters who put their lives on the line have historically been forced into life-threatening scenarios with trucks and equipment barely making the grade. More than $20 million has been spent in the past couple years to upgrade new ambulances, fire engines, lights, sirens, clothing, helmets, body armor, rescue gear, even hearing protection.
All of our energy, the administration, the men and women in the field, is dedicated to providing professional services to them, saving lives and saving property.
Yet, some are raising new questions about how tax dollars are being spent and who is scrutinizing the process. For instance, more than $1 million paid for a demo model platform truck with a ladder that did not fit inside a firehouse it was initially assigned to. Ethics expert and former federal prosecutor Peter Henning says this clearly could have been avoided.
Get out a tape measure and make sure that it fit into your garage. They're using our money, and I want my tax dollars used effectively, and especially for something as important as firefighting.
The man overseeing many of the big ticket purchases is Deputy Fire Commissioner Dave Fornell.
Well, this is our platforms, and yeah, I mean, now we've got a heavy volume stream.
That's him on Action News, recently talking about fighting arson fires. Now he's under fire from some within the department who also question his potential bias as a former truck sales rep.
Well, if you spend money and it don't fit in quarters, you just waste money.
Asking us not to use his full name, Hawk is a retired mechanic who spent a lengthy career repairing vehicles for the fire department. He also now sells fire trucks. He points out he was once a member of an apparatus committee made up of firefighters, mechanics, and other experts who made sure equipment and trucks were ordered correctly. He says Fornell put an end to that committee.
Previous committee, we had paperwork showing every door opening, height, width, and the depth of the quarters. And the reason I know that is I'm the one that went out and measured every firehouse in the city.
Nearly 40 fire stations in the city of Detroit, all with different measurements. Fornell, a top executive, has never personally worked as a Detroit firefighter, instead bringing experience from jobs around the country, including sales for companies like Ferrara and HME. A spokesman for the mayor's office says a different committee is now handling oversight, but they did not provide a list of names when asked. The fire commissioner admits in this case someone made a mistake, but says a solution was quickly reached. He also says it was desperately needed, and ordering a different model could have taken up to 18 months.
The only issue I had was lettering it prior to deploying it. The ladder fits into a firehouse. The ladder is serving the citizens of Detroit.
As for Fornell's previous employment, Jones tells us he was well aware that he once sold trucks from some of the same companies they're now purchasing from. He says that type of background has actually helped the department make better decisions overall, and Fornell has a strong working relationship with the union.
Deputy Commissioner Fornell was brought on for his expertise and that alone. It's a more comprehensive process now. More members are involved. That way we get a better product.
Plans are in the works to continue ordering more equipment, trucks, and tools. In the meantime, the city says no one has been disciplined for ordering a truck that needed to be reassigned to a different house. Simon Chiquette, 7 Action News.
All right, Simon, thank you for the report.